Welcome all of you. I am Anjali Jose, Assistant Professor, Department of Physics, Nirmala College, Mottura. Today, we are discussing about the moment of inertia of flywheel. First, we have to know what is a flywheel. This is a picture of flywheel. In this, we can say that a flywheel is a heavy wheel with a long cylindrical axle passing through its center. Its center of gravity lies on the axis of rotation so that it can come to rest in any desired position. Most of its mass is concentrated at the rim of the wheel. It is so designed to have the large moment of inertia about its axis of rotation. If the moment of inertia is large, its performance in making the running of a machine coupled to the engine will be smooth and steady. There is a small peg on the axle. We have a string which is attached to the peg. The other end of the string carries weight hanger. From the figure, capital N represents the number of windings in the axle. Let M be the mass attached to the weight hanger. The potential energy of the mass is mgh. The flywheel is given a rotation by allowing the mass to descend. Now the potential energy of the mass is lost. After the mass is touched the ground, axle rotates in small n number of times. Initially, the angular velocity is more and let it be omega. Finally, the angular velocity stops and becomes zero. So the average angular velocity omega is equal to the initial angular velocity omega plus 0/2 is equal to omega/2. We know that the angular velocity is 2π/t. If it makes n rotations, the angular velocity is equal to 2πn/t. So w/2 is equal to 2πn/t. Rearranging, omega is equal to 4πn/t. Please remember, the angular velocity of flywheel is omega is equal to 4πn/t, where n is the number of rotations made after the mass is detached. T is the time taken for n such rotations. Using the angular velocity omega, we can find out the kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is equal to 1/2 I omega square. The loss in potential energy, mgh, is utilized for 1. Imparting kinetic energy of rotation 1/2 I omega square to the wheel. 2. Imparting kinetic energy to the mass 1/2 I omega square. And 3, to do work against friction. If capital W is the work done against friction for one rotation, then the total work done against friction is capital NW, where capital N is the number of windings before the mass released. Using the law of conservation of energy, we have loss in potential energy is equal to gain in kinetic energy of the wheel plus gain in kinetic energy of the mass plus work done against friction. In equation form, capital MGH is equal to 1/2 I omega square plus 1/2 mv square plus capital NW. Since small n number of rotations are made after the mass is detached, the kinetic energy of the wheel is 1/2 I omega square is equal to small n W. Then W is equal to 1/2 n I omega square. On substitution, we get capital MGH is equal to 1/2 I omega square plus 1/2 mv square plus ni into omega square/2n. I omega square terms making together, we can write it as MGH is equal to 1/2 mv square plus 1/2 I omega square into 1 plus n by n. For rotational case, as we know, v is equal to r omega, mgh is equal to half m r square omega square plus half I omega square into 1 plus n by n. Making together the terms containing mass, m into 2gh minus r square omega square is equal to I omega square into 1 plus n by n. So, m into 2gh minus r square omega square is equal to I omega square into 1 plus n by n. Then I is equal to m into 2gh minus r square omega square divided by omega square into 1 plus n by n. Then I is equal to mn 2gh by omega square minus r square divided by n plus n. So we got obtained the derivation of or the value of the moment of inertia of flywheel. This equation contains the terms mass, the number of windings before and after the mass detaching, and then omega, and also the radius of the axle as well as the height of the mass from the ground. In this, we have to find the value of omega, as we already know the value of omega is equal to 4 pi n by t. We can find the value of moment of inertia of a flywheel. Thank you.